نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم اما بعد اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم okay thank you for inviting me and I'm really honored to be part of this conference and I really before starting I really want to thank the chair of this meeting and the special thanks to Nagad for organizing this meeting and thanks to Ministry of Employment, Social Affairs and Family and all the representatives from political parties, INGOs, UN agencies and distinguished guests. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for being part of this and I'm also honored, feel honored to be part of this as OXFAM representative. I think this is a very important occasion and this is very important event and this is for the 50% of the population of Somaliland. The women are part of this whole society as a 50% of population. But once we see that in the different decision-making processes, in the political processes, or in the government procedures, or different employment processes, we don't see the representation that they own as a 50% population of this country. And the constitution that I was reading, that is also mentioned that women must be included in all institutions in an effective way. And the word that I was reading was must. It does not mean will or should be. The must mean that there should be effective and affirmative actions to be taken. And being the political representative, being the government representative and being the civil society, I think it is the responsibility of all of us and everybody of us who is sitting here and at the same time who are not sitting here but listening to this and who has the responsibility to implement the constitution of Somaliland. And this is a very important constitutional article which we all have to move forward with. So at the same time, since last one decade, what all the organizations and the government official and the political parties are having regained commitment that there will be increased number of women participation in the leadership position, may it be political electoral processes or may it be the nominated political representation of women in different positions. But in last one decade, there are definitely different steps, different actions were taken, but the outcomes and the results that we yet to see. And for that, I think this today event recall all of us that we take some affirmative action, we put some concrete measures and affirmative actions based on this workshop, based on the constitution of the Somaliland, and at the same time, the commitments that all of us and the government of Somaliland made to the sustainable development goals for the next 15 years. And also some of these things are mentioned in the national development plans. So I hope with this regained commitment and the representation and affirmative action, there will be some positive outcome. The next election is also coming in less than a year time. And I hope there will be some more commitments and specifically from the political parties representative who are here that they nominate more women for the direct election and at different level and different constituencies so that there is more representation from the women. Because we can't feel, and I hope we all understand that what the world would look like if there is no, if there are no women. Definitely they are part of our family, they are part of our society, so why not they should be part of this whole decision making processes where they share that what are the core and important issues that they are facing. So how they can address that, may it be economic side, may it be political side, so they should be empowered throughout all these processes. From OXFAM International, we are committed and we have our core values, empowerment, and it means the empowerment of the whole society, and that includes men, women and youth. And then we also have the inclusiveness, like all these groups and the social groups and specifically women who are marginalized, they should be part of these decision-making processes. And then the accountability, where we put our strong measures and we make sure as OXFAM we are accountable to what action we take, and at the same time we held accountable all the governments, different individuals, as well as the other international actors, so that they put their efforts in this in making sure that these sustainable goals are implemented and these constitutional provisions are implemented and the laws and policies are reformed and formed in a way which are beneficial to all actors of the society and specifically women and youth. So for this, I again reiterate and request all the representatives here, all the government officials who are sitting here, and all the civil society, including the national civil society and international civil society, to play their role in this process. So just to share, like, this event is basically being organized based on the support of European Union, and we are having this 3-year project, and that includes the involving of women and youth in the decision-making processes, so that the we have a prosperous and peaceful Somaliland. So within this, there are different initiatives that we will be taking on, and our partner, the consortia partner, is NAGAD, which is a national NGO and which has organized this event. And the other partner is SONIO, and I'm really thankful to both of the partners for being part of this initiative and working for the rights and of the women and improvement on the of the social and economic well-being for the women of Somaliland. I hope with this, once we conclude this event, there will be a concrete action plan and clear recommendation for the government, for the civil society, as well as for the international community. And on this note, I'm thankful to all of you for being part of this initiative. And definitely from our side, we will continue our commitment and support for the women of Somaliland and working with the government and civil society, as well as the political representative. Thank you all.